Okay, good morning. We'll start today's fluid mechanics class. So how are all of you? Okay. Yeah, so welcome to this fluid mechanics class. Today, we are going to continue with studies. This is the last in the fourth module. So I want all of you to just see the WhatsApp group. Few problems, 3-4 problems on lift and drag. Just open that, please. On drag and lift, some 3-4 problems I've sent. Please see that one. Can you please open that? Today I sent problems on lift and drag. Okay, just open that, please. Okay. So, I will start with the first one, the example 8.4. Example 8.4 is given there. Okay. I just want to do this once again. We spoke about two things. One is called the lift drag. I told you lift acts in the vertical direction and drag acts in the horizontal direction. Drag is a pull. Okay. And while lift is a perpendicular motion. Now, we took the example of an aircraft. An aircraft has to be lifted up. So a lift force is there, that is in perpendicular direction. And it has to move horizontally in the air. So a drag force is required in order to pull the aircraft and make it to move along a line. Okay, so that is called the drag. We also spoke about the force, drag force, that is FD, and lift force FL. And we also said that the drag force FD is equal to CD A rho U square by 2, where CD is the coefficient of drag, A is the area, rho is the density of the fluid, and U is the velocity. So based on that, we can decide what is drag force. You can calculate what is the drag force. Similarly, we have one more, which is called the lift force. So lift force, what is lift force? Same thing, FL is equal to, instead of coefficient of drag, you will have coefficient of lift. So FL is equal to CL into A rho U square by 2. That is the only difference. All other things will remain the same. So in example 8.4, he has given a problem. See, these are the kind of problems you will get in the fourth module. Small problems in the main exam also. I'm asking you to do these problems. See here, calculate the diameter of a parachute. Okay. Some parachute is there and the parachute is coming downwards. Okay. Now calculate the diameter of the parachute to be used for dropping an object weighing 1 kN. So the weight is 1 kN. So that the maximum terminal velocity of dropping is 5 m/s. So velocity is 5 m/s. The drag coefficient of the parachute treated as hemispherical, see, is given the figure here, the shape of the parachute is 1.3. That means CD drag coefficient is 1.3. The maximum density of air is 1.2 kg/m³. Now, you have to consider the parachute as a hemisphere. So you can see here, the parachute like this, and then the top there will be a hemisphere. The weight is acting downwards. See the figure there. Now he's asking you to find the diameter of the parachute. Okay, FD. So drag force he has given. So you have to use the drag force. FD is equal to CD A rho U square by 2. So what is the force? Object weighing 1 kN, that is 1000. F is equal to 1000 is equal to CD 1.3 into area π/4d² cross-sectional area into density 1.2 he has given into velocity 5 m/s, 5 / 2. So the only unknown factor is D. Solve for D. D is equal to root of so much. You will get D is equal to 8.8 m. So in the fourth module, you are going to get small problems like this. Okay, so maybe 5 marks, 6 marks, like that. Then coming to example 8.5, a plate 1.5 meter by 1.5 meter moves at 50 kilometers per hour in stationary air of specific weight 1.15 kg per meter cube. If the coefficients of drag and lift are 0.15 and 0.75 respectively, determine first drag force, second lift force, third one resultant force, fourth one power required to keep the plate in motion. Power required to keep the plate in motion. Okay. Now, what are the quantities that are given when you start solving? First one, what should you do first? Velocity of the plate, u. How much it is? 50 kilometers per hour. U is equal to 50 kilometers per hour. Now, your unit is what? Meter per second. Convert it from kilometers per hour to meter per second. Okay, so 50 kilometers, convert it to meter. 50 into 1000, so it will become meter per hour. Convert it to second. 60 into 60, 3600. Divided by 3600, you will get u is equal to 13.89 meters. Keep the velocity in kilometers. Keep it in meter per second. Then, what is asked to calculate? First one, drag force. We have drag force. What is the formula? Fd is equal to Cd, rho a u square by 2. So Fd is equal to, what is Cd? Yes, given, 0.15. Into density is how much? 1.15 is given. Specific weight means density only. Specific weight is nothing but density only. 1.15 into area. 1.5 into 1.5. It is a flat plate. Into velocity, 13.89 square divided by 2. So drag force is equal to 37.44 newtons. Then lift force, FL is equal to, instead of CD, you will have CL, that's all. CL into rho a square by 2. So all other things are same. Substitute for CL, 0.75. Calculate, you will get lift force is equal to 187.2 newton. Then he's asking resultant force. I told you, lift force is perpendicular, drag force is horizontal. So resultant force will be at 45 degrees only. So it's a diagonal. So it will be resultant force R is will be equal to root of, it is a Pythagoras theorem, of Fd square plus Fl square, which is substitute for Fd and Fl, you will get resultant force 190.91 newton. Then power required to keep the plate in motion. That means what is the power required to see that the plate keeps on moving? So what should be the force? Lift force will not come into picture because it's moving horizontally. So it will be Fd, drag. You have to drag it into what? How much? Velocity into u. So it will be 37.44 into velocity is 13.89. You will get so many watts. If you divide by 1000, you will get 0.52 kilowatt. Okay. Yeah. So you have another similar problem here like this. A flat plate 2 meter by, next problem, example 4. A flat plate 2 meter by 2 meter moves with a velocity 50 kilometers per hour, which is 1.15. If coefficient of lift and drag are 0.5, calculate drag, lift force, resultant force. I will tell you, this is a common question in all VTO question papers. From many years, they are giving this question. So you will get this for, say, 6 months or something like that. Okay. Now, what is this? Velocity of the plate, u kilometers per hour. So, compared to meter per second, u 13.8 meter per second. Next, Fd is Fd rho u square by 2. Substitute all the values are given. Find drag force. Lift force, Fd equals CL rho u square by 2. Substitute all the values. Fl you can find. Resultant root of Fd square plus Fl square. 339.4 newton. Simple problem. Very, very simple substitution. These are the places where you can grab the marks. These are the places where you can grab marks. Okay. So small, small things. You put it in your pocket, you can grab the marks fast. Okay, so this module in this topic is what you can graph, and very easily you can score the marks in this one. Okay, so after that, just see in the WhatsApp group, I have given the material. After this, I have given a series of equations. Just see that series of equations are there. They are all the important equations of this chapter. So just go through that. You don't have to see the whole, read the whole chapter. See, laminar boundary layer, turbulent boundary layer, sublayer, boundary thickness. So you start from boundary thickness, boundary layer thickness, boundary layer thickness definition. Then displacement thickness, delta star, definition, formula. See, I have given you this, which will be very helpful for you. Directly you can see this and solve the problem. Then momentum thickness theta is equal to, is given the formula for that. Then energy thickness, delta double star, formula for that. Okay. Then boundary layer separation, not required for you. And lift and drag, Fd is equal to Fr cos theta, Fl sin, and Fr sin theta. See, if the plate is kept at an angle, then theta will come into picture and you have to take the angle theta into consideration. Then drag coefficient Cd. So from the same equation, he has taken Cd. It is equal to Fd by half rho u square. Then lift coefficient Cl. Then resultant force Fr. Okay. Then I told you yesterday, there are three types of drag. One is called skin friction drag. Other is called the pressure drag. So total drag will be pressure drag plus skin friction drag. And he has given the mathematical formula for that. The total drag is called the skin friction drag. Okay, this is what I wanted to tell you regarding the fourth module, flow in immersed bodies. Okay, now this is a ready reckoner for you. You just to have that page with you, all the formula you are going to get. What is boundary layer thickness, momentum thickness, displacement thickness, energy thickness. Formula is there. Directly you substitute and find all the results. Okay. So this is a simple thing. Now, any doubts you have, you please ask, because we are completed module 4. Any doubts, please? Module 4 is completed now. Yes, please. Any doubts? Yes. Any doubts, please?
No doubts, sir.
Okay, shall I proceed? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, yeah. So with this, the module 4 is completed. Sir, we are left with only module 5. Okay. Now, I'll just give a brief introduction to module 5 and then start off the module 5. Actually. Now, so far, whatever we have studied is all incompressible flow. Incompressible flow means what? Density is constant. Example, water. But there are substances which are compressible. What are they? Gases. Gases are compressible. Air is compressible. Neon, argon, etc. Many gases are there. Nitrogen, hydrogen. They are all compressible gases. So far, whatever we studied, all the assumptions, all the theories are all based on incompressible flow where density is constant. So we say that when incompressible flow is there, it is applicable to fluids where density is constant and they follow Newton's law of viscosity, they follow Bernoulli's equation, they follow Euler's theorem, Bernoulli's theorem, all these things they follow. Okay, so far whatever we have studied till now, till the fourth module, all are ideal fluids and incompressible fluids, and we have assumed that flow is steady. So in those cases only, we can use Bernoulli's theorem, Euler's theorem, and Pascal's law, whatever it is, everything you can use only for incompressible flow. But now we are going to study about the fifth module is only about compressible flow, where density is not constant. Density is not constant. So when density is not constant, that means what? It is varying. Density is varying. So if you take some gas, okay, the gas starts varying. The gas behaves in a different way for different pressure and different temperature. All of you know that. So when we talk about gases, we come to the equation, yes, which is the equation, ideal gas equation, PV is equal to MRT, isn't it? PV is equal to MRT. So PV is equal to MRT is the ideal gas equation. P is the pressure, V is the volume, and is equal to M into RT. R is the constant, and T is the temperature. Now, an ideal gas, we say, for an ideal gas, PV is equal to MRT. Okay. Now, R is called the gas constant. P is the pressure. V is the volume of the gas in meter cube. M, small m, is the mass of the gas. Okay. PV is equal to MRT is called the ideal gas equation or the perfect gas equation, where P is the pressure, V is the volume in meter cube, M is the mass of the gas in kg, and R is called the gas constant, and R is equal to 287, you know that value, 287 joule per kg Kelvin for air. R is equal to 287 for air. Then this is called the equation of state or the ideal gas equation or perfect gas equation, PV is equal to MRT. So in the compressible flow, we know that the density is changing with pressure. Density changes with temperature. So many variables start coming now. And the whole theory of incompressible flow cannot be used for compressible flow. So this is a different concept altogether. Okay, so when we talk about the gas, we are going to talk about many things now. In ATD, initially you have seen what are the different processes for a gas. So what are they? Isothermal process, adiabatic process, etc. Isn't it? So one by one, we'll see what are the different processes. So all these things you will be studying in ATD also. You know these things, isn't it? Okay. Now, we are going to talk about the isothermal process, adiabatic process, etc. So isothermal process, isothermal, that means temperature is constant. Isothermal, iso means constant. So temperature is constant. So it's a constant temperature process. Is equal to P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 is equal to constant, or P by rho is equal to constant. Now, we say that a process is called an isothermal process when P by rho is equal to constant or P1 is equal to constant, temperature is constant. Second one, the adiabatic process. It is one where gas neither absorbs nor rejects heat to the surroundings. Okay, there is no heat loss. Okay, so for an adiabatic process, all of you know, PV to the power of K is equal to V1 to the power of K, equal to P2 V2 to the power of K is equal to constant, or P by rho to the power of K is equal to constant, where K is called specific heat, ratio of specific heats. K is equal to ratio of specific heats. Also, you studied in ATD that K is equal to Cp by Cv. You know that, isn't it? You can call it as K or gamma, whatever it is. Both are same. So, gamma or K is equal to Cp by Cv. That's equal to 1.4 for A. Gamma is equal to 1.4. You can also call it as K. K or gamma is equal to 1.4. And gamma is equal to Cp by Cv. Then we have isentropic process. What is an isentropic process? A reversible adiabatic process is called an isentropic process. It is a frictional adiabatic process. It's a frictionless adiabatic process, and hence it is reversible. So it's a reversible process. Therefore, entropy remains constant. It is an ideal process and it cannot be achieved in practice. So it's very difficult to have a reversible process and entropy is constant. Cannot have that. It is only an ideal case. So what are the studies? What is isothermal process? Temperature is constant. P V1 equals P2, V2 is equal to constant, and PV is equal to constant. Then adiabatic process, PV to the power of gamma is equal to P1, V1 equal to P2, V2 to the power of gamma is equal to constant. That gamma equal to Cp by Cv. So these things all of you have studied the basics in thermodynamics. So because you're studying the theory about the gases, that is compressible flow, we need to understand all these processes. Then what is the entropy? Next point, entropy, it is defined as a measure of maximum heat energy available for conversion into work. So how much energy is available to convert into work? And entropy ds is given by, yes, dq by t, or entropy change s2 by s1 is equal to integral of dq by t from the process 1 to 2. Okay, so entropy also you should know, ds is equal to dq by t. Then another one which is common for all of you, you might have heard everywhere, is called the enthalpy. In first year engineering also, when you study steam, you are going to read about enthalpy. It is nothing but the heat content of the gas, heat content present in the gas, H. And H is equal to U plus PV. H is equal to U plus PV. That is internal energy U plus product of pressure into volume. H is equal to enthalpy. H is equal to U plus PV. See, all these things you have studied already. It's just that we are refreshing all these things, the various processes, when you are studying about the gases. In thermodynamics, you are going to study all the basics. Then bulk modulus K is equal to rho into dp by d rho. That is called the bulk modulus. Then continuity equation, we are going to talk about continuity equation. Rho AV is equal to constant. Or dp by rho plus dA by A plus dV by B equal to zero. So this is the continuity equation also, which you are going to study. You know about the continuity equation. Yes, till now whatever we have done, any doubts, please ask now. Yeah, tell me.
So from the last module, can you once explain what total drag is?
I can't hear you. What is total?
So can you once explain what total drag is?
Total drag?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll just tell you. Yeah, like in the last module, I'll just explain once again. Two things are there. One is drag. The other is lift. So you have drag force. We have lift force. Drag force is equal to coefficient of drag CD into rho A U square by 2. Similarly, lift force is equal to coefficient of lift CL into rho A U square by 2. Okay? So I defined drag force, I defined lift force. Now, you take an aircraft, for example, both are acting. Drag force is also acting. Lift force is also acting. Lift force is lifting the aeroplane. Drag force is pulling it along the horizontal line. It has to move in the air. When such a case is happening, drag force is also there, lift force is also there. What is the resultant force acting on the aircraft? What is the resultant force acting on the aircraft? Drag force is horizontal.
Total drag.
Lift force is perpendicular. Total drag force. Resultant force. Total drag force is different. Total drag force is the drag force. That's all. What I'm telling is the resultant force. Resultant force will be equal to, so if this is perpendicular, lift force is perpendicular, drag force is horizontal, resultant force will be 45 degrees, the diagonal, isn't it? So apply the Pythagoras theorem, so you will get resultant force is equal to root of drag force plus square root of Fd square. Hello. Hello.
Yes,
Okay. So you are asking about the total drag force and lift force. Did you understand now? Could you hear me?
So I think you were cut off in
Hello.
the between. Like you were explaining and then you cut off.
Okay. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, I'll continue. Yeah, Jayant, I'll just continue. So I was just telling you that if you take an aircraft, it has got both lift component of the force, that is FL, which is acting perpendicular, horizontal. So when you take the resultant force, it will be one is horizontal, the other is vertical, 90 degrees. So the resultant will be at 45 degrees. Apply the Pythagoras, you will get resultant force along the diagonal will be equal to FD root square root of F plus FL square. Got it? That is called the resultant force, not the total drag force. Drag force FD is equal to, I told you, CD into rho A u square by 2. Whereas lift force FL is equal to CL into rho A u square by 2. So find drag force, find lift force. Resultant force will be equal to square root of d square plus FL square. That will give the resultant force. Because resultant force is acting at 45 degrees along the diagonal. Okay, so that is why you find the resultant force. Okay, tell me, any other doubts?
So then what is skin
I think, Jayant, the
drag?
doubt is clear
Yes.
now. What
What
is?
is skin friction drag?
Yeah, that's what yesterday we were discussing about that. See, if you take a plate along the boundary of the plate, on the skin of the plate, okay, there is a drag. Okay, there is a pull on the plate, on the skin of the plate, or you can say top layer of the plate. That is called skin friction drag. That is called skin friction drag. There is one more drag which depends on the shape of the body. That is called pressure drag. Okay, it could be a sphere. Or it depends on the geometry of the body. That is called pressure drag. See, for example, you take submarine. The shape of the submarine is different. Whereas if you take some other object, that object geometry is different. So based on the geometry, pressure acting is different. That drag is called pressure drag. Okay. See, if you take a ball or a sphere, put it in water, for example, then the geometry is a sphere. So pressure acting on that depends on the geometry of the sphere. Whereas if you take a submarine, it has got a different geometry. So the drag acting on that geometry is called pressure drag. That is different for each geometry. That is called pressure drag. Then friction drag, skin friction drag is the drag acting along the top surface of the, or you can say skin of the plate or whatever it is, wherever the drag is acting. That is called skin friction drag because that is. There is a friction on the topmost layer of the plate or the body, whatever you are considering. Did you understand now? Any doubts, please?
Yes, I understand.
Understood, no? So those are the different types of drag. So what you need to study in the fourth module is first one, dimensional analysis. Second one is the boundary layer theory. In the boundary layer theory, definition of momentum thickness, energy thickness, displacement thickness, boundary layer thickness, mathematical formula for each of them. I have given you in the group only, I have posted it. Ready made, you have got all the formula for that. You can directly substitute. Then, after that, you have got what is drag, what is lift, what is friction drag, what is skin friction drag, what is pressure drag. Then, what is FD, drag force. What is lift force? What is CD, coefficient of drag? What is CL, coefficient of lift? What is the resultant root of FD square plus FL square? So these are the things that you have to take care while doing the fourth module. And you should also solve some problems. I have given you sample problems on finding FD, CD. Just now I did a problem on finding diameter of the parachute. So small problems they will give based on this formula, drag and lift. See, this is a very easy module where you can grab the marks very easily. Okay, drag, lift, and all very easy. They'll give small.
Class over.
Yeah, can you hear me? Yeah, some internet problem.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, there's some internet problem. So yeah, we had to got cut off. Okay. Anyway, I was telling you about the compressible flow. See, it obeys the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to MRT, and there are different kinds of processes for gases. They follow those rules and they obey those laws. You have studied in thermodynamics already. What are the processes? Isothermal process, adiabatic process, isentropic process, etc. So isothermal process, temperature is constant, PV is equal to constant, or P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. Then second one, adiabatic process, PV to the power of gamma is equal to constant, where gamma is called the ratio of specific heats. Gamma is equal to Cp by Cv. Okay, gamma is equal to Cp by Cv. Then you know those, all these things you know already. So they are the fundamentals. Then isentropic process is nothing but a reversible adiabatic process, which is ideal and it is not possible. Okay, these are some of the processes that we are studying. Then after that, we have got what is called as the enthalpy. Enthalpy S is equal to integral of dQ by T. And entropy is defined as a measure of maximum heat energy available for conversion into work. Okay. Then you have the enthalpy, which is the heat content of any gas, which is called H. It is equal to U plus PV, where U is equal to internal energy, and PV is the product of pressure and volume. Then bulk modulus K is equal to rho into dP by d rho. Then, and for isothermal process, K is equal to P, and isentropic isothermal process, K is equal to P, and isentropic, K is equal to K, small k into P. Then you have finally the continuity equation, rho AV is equal to constant, and you get d rho by rho plus dA by A plus dV by V is equal to zero. So these are the basic fundamentals that we are going to study. We have already studied in the thermodynamics also. Okay, all these laws will be applicable in the gases, okay, which are compressible. So the fifth module is only about compressible gases. Okay, so compressible flow. So we have to study the various processes. I've just given the introduction of all the basic processes. After this, we are going to study what are the different kinds of velocity. What is velocity of sound? What is velocity of light, wave propagation? All those things we are going to study in the fifth module. So for today, I think it is enough. We have completed sufficient portions today, and I have given the introduction to the fifth module also. Okay, so we'll stop at this during the session. And one thing I would like to tell all of you, those who have not submitted assignment one, listen carefully. Those are not submitted assignment one, submit immediately, because first test is over already. If you have not submitted assignment one, you will lose marks. Be careful. Then start submitting assignment two. I have put in the group, 14th May is the last date to submit assignment two. So please start submitting assignment two immediately. Okay, start submitting assignment two immediately. It's very important. All of you, please finish assignment 2 and submit before 14th May. Okay? These things I would like to tell you. Okay? Those who have not submitted assignment 1, please make sure. But by the end of the day, if you do not submit, you will lose marks. Be careful. Please submit FM assignment 1. Those who have not submitted. Okay? Others, start submitting assignment 2. Last date is 14th May. Okay? So four modules are completed as of now, and I given the introduction to the fifth module. Maybe in another 4 or 5 classes, we might complete the fifth module also. Okay, any doubts, queries, please come up. Yeah. Please ask any doubts, queries, whatever you have.